Dire team ban.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Join Dota League. We've got a best of two Radiant series here between SADBOYS and Team eHug. It almost looked like for a second we weren't going to make it in the lobby, but thank God we did. There's a lot of all chatting, a lot of lobby talk, and it kind of seems like this is an NEL game for those of you familiar with the league, because you look at all of these players, obviously all from North America, and you've got so many players that played in the NEL, just a lot of in-house players, almost a lot of pub stars as well when you think about it, but there's a lot more at stake, obviously. It is this best of two series between eHug and, of course, SADBOYS, also known as Arizona Iced Out Boys, and both teams are kind of relatively new, and it's exciting because this is going to be, I think, a new step in the right direction for American Dota. We have a couple more teams on the rise, obviously these two at the forefront, and it's always nice to see new teams, up-and-coming teams, play and duke it out here, especially teams that are very familiar with one another. Obviously, you know, PPD putting this team together with Fear Universe, Zai, and RTZ, very strong team, a lot of individual talent going on that side. On the other side of things, eHug changing things around. Sleazel, who used to be part of Pretty Boy Swag, not able to make it to the team house for in New York City for Team eHug, and they're using MSS right now as a stand-in. So, both strong teams, and they've had a lot of good results as of recently. Obviously, in the Join Dota League, I believe eHug has won their first best of two series already, whereas SADBOYS lost 2-0 to Team Liquid not too long ago. So eHug is looking to add a win, and SADBOYS is looking to get on track here. So once again, my name is Maut. Thank you for joining us. We're already well into the draft. Remember, this is 6.80, so there's a couple different things you have to keep in mind with the draft as we go along. Some of the heroes aren't necessarily as strong, but for the most part, the draft should be pretty similar to 6.79. So I'm excited to see what we're going to have here for the draft. And so far, we're going to start with the Clockwork and the next Assassin Bag from SADBOYS. And on the other side of things, Visage and the Outworld Devourer. And we'll see SADBOYS go for the Timbersaw. He did lose a little bit of his strength, obviously, with, of course, the nerf going to him, but still pretty good. He's not as tanky as he used to be. You can't really kind of just say, throw him in the lane and he'll just win every lane. It's not as easy as he used to be, but he's still very, very strong. He has a lot of burst damage, obviously, and pure damage, which is very, very nice. So, alright. Looking at it right now, I mean, Team eHug, they've got the next two picks here, and it's going to be interesting because they really like picking around Reborus. Of course, he is the mid player, and Ryu and RTZ are very familiar with playing each other one-on-one. They do it a lot in the NEL. They've done a lot in different tournaments and 1v1 matches. So, you know, we'll see if they want to get something for Ryu, like a DK. Maybe they go for a Pugna. They can't go for an OD because they banned it out themselves. So it's going to be RTZ. I guess the A-God versus the R-God, and some people will say, well, no, Relic's the R-God. But I feel like Ryu kind of took that title over, as he played really well in the coming months towards MLG, and he's been playing really well in the past couple of days, especially if you saw that Rock's Kiss game. I think he was the DK in that game. He just did so much work, and I think that was for the ESP Cup, and that was just a lot of fun to watch. So they're going to go for the Luna instead, and MSS plays a very strong Luna, can get some farm as well, and I think MSS and Ryu were kind of not comfortable going in the carry slot until recently, so I think they've been practicing that, trying to figure out what they can do to make it, you know, a little bit easier on those players to say, okay, we can pick up a Luna now, we can get farm, we can play very aggressively, and we can just kind of play our own game, whereas before, it's like Ryu and MSS are both mid players, so kind of like switching between mid and carry. I mean, there is a, you know, a bit of a similarity there, but it's still kind of different because you're not controlling the game as you would with your mid hero. So that's the difference here. And there's another pick coming out from Team eHug right now, and you know, they got a couple of options. We'll see what they want to go, but I mean, Luna's a very good start. They have 1 minute 26 left in reserve time already. The important thing to remember, this is a best of two series. It's not a best of three, and that can be confusing at times, but remember, guys, it's just two games, just two. No matter what, it's only two games tonight, so there's no real, you know, third game tiebreak, and they could split the series right now, and that would be very interesting, I think. I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, who comes out on top in this first game, because I feel like the momentum is going to carry heavily into that second game, but yeah, I don't know. This is going to be fun. This is good old NA Dota, and people were asking me how hyped I am for this match, and I'm pretty hyped. I mean, it's not often we get to see two American teams duke it out. In fact, it's been a while, because, like, you go back to last season, like, when Dignitas was still a thing, when Liquid was still a thing, and when EG was still a thing, and it was a lot of fun to watch those three teams compete. Now it's kind of like Speed is kind of in there to a certain extent, but it's good to see eHug and SADBOYS getting back into it with Liquid also being very, very strong as of recently. So Team eHug, they're going to go for the Enchantress right now, and Sheep plays very strong Enchantress, very good jungle player. He did play that Enchantress in that Rock's Kiss game like I was talking about. What I want to talk about a little bit also is SADBOYS, actually, they have two offlane players that are very, very strong, and they kind of just, last time, I think, I'm pretty sure the universe is really known to play very strong offlane, but Zai can do that as well. And it's kind of surprising to me see Zai in that support role, because I feel like Universe could be just as good there, but that's kind of what they were thinking about, I think. And also, in a game where they beat Speed, I think it was the game where they picked Sven for Arteezy in the mid lane, they kind of, like, they had Fear in the Bounty Hunter, which was very interesting, so they switched a lot of the roles around in that game too. But they're going to go for the Lion right now, and that's a pretty interesting hero. I mean, the only thing that was changed was the Aghanim's for the finger, but he's still, I think, a pretty good hero because he has the Earth Spike, he's got the Hex, and Hex is really nice to have. Also, Mana Drain is a bit better than it used to be, like a year ago. That thing was god-awful, and now it's actually somewhat decent, so there is that. Obviously, any sort of magic immunity is going to make Lion kind of useless, so BKB on Luna is going to be very helpful, but obviously that's not going to matter for an Enchantress or any other supports in the game, so... I do like this pickup. I think it's kind of aggressive, and that's cool, because I think with a new team, you also need to kind of have a new playstyle or try out a couple new heroes, and so they're going to go with the Lion right now, and we'll have some bans as well. The Pugna, the Venomancer on one side, and on the other side of things, you have the Darkseer and the Shadow Fiend. Just, they're really kind of targeting their bans towards Arteezy and Universe with, of course, the Darkseer. Obviously, the Viz is just a good hero in general, but, I mean, this is... They really just don't want Arteezy to get a decent hero, and I don't blame them, because he could just dominate a game if he gets something that can really do well for him. So, just like, all right, guys, we're going to shut down Arteezy, and we're going to win the game. And we'll see if they could do that. I mean, Arteezy has a couple other heroes in the bank that he could pick out. But, you know, I'm interested to see. I mean, because like I talked about, they went for the Sven the other time against Speed Gaming. They did very well with that. I mean, an inherently tanky hero with a nice stun. And he got a Blink Dagger. He was able to just control the pace of the game. And I thought that was, you know, pretty exceptional to watch. So, 45 seconds left to reserve time right now for eHug. And with the Luna, with the Enchantress, they can pick up another support here for a laner. Something like a Crystal Maiden, despite that base intelligence nerf. Bane might be good in this scenario. They can even go for the mid hero, like a DK, which was not banned out. The only thing the DK was changed, of course, was the Dragon Tail. Now it's a 12-second cooldown, and it drops down lower until you get to 9-second cooldown at its fourth level, which is actually kind of a pretty significant nerf, because in early on in the game, when you're fighting very, you know, when you're fighting a lot and you're just throwing out Dragon Tails, it's nice to have that 9-second cooldown. But, you know, I'm not sure if they're going to go for that. They're taking a lot of time here to think about what they want to do. Like, okay, we got 6 seconds of reserve time. Let's do something. Can we do something? Can we do something? They're going to go for the Bane. Called it. All right, got it. So they've got Lockdown now with, you know, Fiend's Grip. He does have to hit level 6, but with a dual lane, you know, Bane, Luna, there should be a little bit more room to get experience there, and I like that. The Enchantress can roam through and try to grab a kill on the Tibbersaw if they decide to offlane that Tibbersaw and not do something like a solo safe lane if they don't want to aggro try or something like that. But for Arizona SADBOYS, for SADBOYS, they can go for their mid hero now. They can go for their carry. It depends on what they value. There's still a lot of heroes in the pool. 10 seconds remaining. There's still plenty of options they can go for. Maybe even a lifestealer if they want to head down that route, which has fallen out of favor a little bit, but it's still a very strong carry, and for good reason.
Reserve time.
It really all depends on what they want to pick up here, and is it going to be your mid? Is it going to be a support? Is it going to be your carry? There's a whole lot of options for them, and I don't, you know, I'm not going to theorycraft and say, oh, they're going to pick this up, they're going to pick that up. We'll just wait and see what they go for. So, I don't know. Looking at eHug's lineup right now, I like the fact that they have a Bane, because you can just enfeeble whoever you want to enfeeble, including a lifestealer or whoever. And, yeah. And I actually don't expect anybody to pick anything like a Death Prophet anymore. I feel like it wasn't just the Death Prophet that got nerfed, it was also the Necrobook that got nerfed very hard, and just kind of pushing in general to a certain extent. Pugna was kind of ones that didn't get didn't get touched, and same with the Nature's Prophet. He didn't really get touched either, but I don't see them picking up a Furion here because you have already a Tibbersaw, and you're probably going to play him in the offlane, so... that would be something you could pick up for eHug, though, and I know Cakes loves to play that Nature's Prophet, so maybe keep that in mind for eHug. So, on the other side of things, I don't really know. I mean, with a Lion, you don't really know what they're kind of aiming towards here. And I think that's nice, just to keep it out in the open. They're going to go for their second support. That's going to be the Crystal Maiden. I like this because they have a lot of roaming potential to go on mid and just kill whoever is sitting mid. With a Crystal Maiden, Frostbite, Lion's Earthspike, as well as some significant damage early on in the game for roaming and for being very effective in lane. So their laning presence is going to be better if they aggro tri lane against the Luna and the Bane. They just need another hero to combo up with it. And something like a Sven could be used in that scenario. Just have another stun and be very tanky. You won't be able to do the most damage in the world because you're going to get kited by a Luna or Bane, but... I still think it'd be kind of useful if they wanted to be a little bit, like, courageous with their picks here, I guess. Just like, 5 seconds okay, remaining. I do over Sven. I mean, there are other really good options also. Batrider going to come out for eHug right now, and a hero that's been picked a little bit, Naga Siren. That's what I was forgetting. I'm like, there was one hero I knew Arteezy loved to play. It's probably that one. Naga Siren. I mean, There was like a period of like a week where he played that hero straight on his stream for like, maybe not a week, but it was a lot of games on that Naga Siren. He loves that hero, and it's high armor, a lot of nuke damage early on with Riptide, and it's a low mana cost spell as well. I mean, only 80 mana at its first level, and it does 130 damage, plus it reduces armor, and it's only a 10-second cooldown. It's a really good ability, plus you have Ensnare, which has always been good, and Naga Siren Sing is really nice as well. So they go with the Naga Siren. This is what Arteezy is comfortable with, and I imagine he will be going mid with that. I'd be very surprised to see them play that in any other role. And Batrider for eHug, they can either offlane that, they can mid that with Ryu. I'm not sure how comfortable he is with Batrider. I think he's done okay with it in the past, but it's not one of his more well-known heroes. Like, maybe, like, Storm Spirit's pretty good for him. Magnus is one of his well-known heroes, obviously. DK, like I talked about, Pugna, OD, even Razor to a certain extent, I think. So, eHug right now, they've got their last pickup here, and they're going to have to find a way to deal with this Naga Siren, and that's going to be tough. You have a Batrider now. You could always just last it, but they are going to go for that Death Prophet, and I was saying earlier, maybe they don't pick that up, and I knew Ryu loves playing that hero, but there was a change. I think it was about 15 seconds in, and that's not the change that is really the big change. It's the Necro Book, but you don't have to go for the Necro Book. You can go for those Yule Scepter. You can go for a Heart eventually, and you can just be able to tank up a lot of the damage, even just, you know, Yules yourself into the air, and essentially get out of the team fight while your Death Prophet Exorcism is going. So that's going to be the mid here, I think. It's going to be Ryu on the Death Prophet. Batrider will be offlane or solo safe, and then enchant the jungle, Bane Luna, into a dual lane. But now the question is, do you go for an aggro tri lane here for PPD and his team of sad boys? I'm not sure myself. I mean, there's a whole lot of options that they could pick up with this carry and be very aggressive with. And with the Crystal Mane, you could roam into the jungle and get levels as well, which is easier to do, you know, in a safe tri lane. But it's up to what, you know, they have a couple of options here, so we'll wait. 20 seconds left in reserve time. The last pick's going to come through in just a moment here, and then we'll be ready to go in the first game here on the Join Dota League. Once again, thank you for joining me. My name is Maut. We'll be underway in just a moment. 10 seconds, in fact, so. And it's going to be the Mirana. So with the Naga Siren, with the Crystal Mane, with the line, there's a whole lot of damage they can do, including just hitting that arrow very easily. And Fear's going to play that Mirana, and I'm excited to see it as well. It should be very interesting, and if they can get a lot of the ganks going here, we'll see. We're going to jump into the game, like I keep talking about, but boom. All right. Just waiting on one player. It's going to be Zai, who's probably AFK. Picking up the line there. So like I was talking about, Zai, going to be supporting now. Kind of a different role than what he's used to, obviously. In State Free, he did play that offlane role, played it very well as well. I think he did the same when he played for SSD, but I might be wrong here, so. All right, here we go. Introductions, I guess. On the side of eHug, on the Radiant team, we have, of course, Reborus will be on the Death Prophet down to that bottom lane. Kicks will be on the Batrider as well, heading down to the bottom lane. Oh, man. Pendega will be on the Bane. MSS will be on the Luna. And I'm a Sheep Sucks will be on the Enchantress. Good old Arteezy. I'm being flamed, everybody. On the side of SADBOYS, you have Universe on the Timbersaw. We'll have Arteezy in that mid-Naga Siren. No surprise there. Up at the top lane, we'll have Fear on the Mirana. PPD will be on the Crystal Maiden, and Zai will be on the line. So they're going to go defensive try, not going to do aggressive. And this is better. This is going to give Fear a lot of opportunities to farm. And we'll see if he wants to roam around and get kills with that Mirana, because you can do so with, you know, Moonlight Shadow, Sacred Arrow. And I think they probably will. I mean, 6.80 kind of favors ganking and being aggressive, so I'd be surprised if they don't do something as a team early on. But it is going to be a dual lane, at least with MSS here, as well as Pandago in the top lane. And the Enchantress is going to be maybe joining them. So it might be an aggro try with a I'm a Sheep Sucks Enchantress, which would be very interesting. Maybe they're thinking about dodging the aggressive try lane that's going to be coming out from SADBOYS. I don't know. Maybe there's mind games going on right now. Who knows? Universe is going to be down to that bottom lane. He does have that Stout Shield. You can already see they've warded here. A nice little ward just to give them vision. Cakes is rotating. They're just trying to find vision and see what's going on. And yeah, they're going to dodge that tri lane top. MSS is going to head down to that bottom lane. I was going to say, like, you really don't want to fight into that. I don't think that'd be difficult at best. So MSS is going to run to the lane right now. He might miss a last hit or two, but he should be just fine. And Sheep's going to head there as well. And this is going to be Pandago in the offlane for right now. And we'll see where they send everybody. I think they want to get the Batrider up there in just a moment before they decide to do anything crazy or split the jungle, which would be very, very disconcerting. So Pandago's got to be careful. He could obviously just throw Enfeeble up on the Mirana if necessary, but, like, I don't really know if you want to use that. You might need Nightmare to get out of a gank. PPD has Haste Rune. There's going to be the Hex as well. Frostbite might go in a second, and it will. Arrow's going to fly here in a moment. There's the Arrow. Stunning Pandago. First Blood is going to go, but the Nightmare first. He will fall. Can he deny himself? No. Lion gets the kill. Nice play. Fear will take up the Nightmare in the end, but Yeah, he was a little too far overextended, unfortunately, so it's just an easy kill going to SADBOYS. A little bit of a misplay, I feel like, coming out from Pandago. However, should be just fine for eHug. They'll get back into it, and Pandago is going to head back top, and he still has to be careful here, so we'll keep our eye on that lane. For now, MSS in the bottom lane should be getting decent farm up against Universe until he gets some decent levels in Timber Chain and uses Rolling Death just to harass MSS out of lane. Right now, he's only got his point into reactive armor, but he'll be level 2 sooner rather than later. So, all quiet on the Western front right now. RTZ in the mid lane just trying to get last hits. He's at 5 right now, and Ryu's sitting at 5 as well, so pretty even. Obviously, the denies are actually going to, you know, RTZ and his Nagasaren, but maybe they go for a gank here pretty soon. I mean, you got Sheep with a smoke going through. He has the Ursa Warrior. He's got the Dark Troll Summoner as well, but you can see the wave has actually pushed in a little bit. Arteezy's going to have to just last it under the towers. Ryu's just throwing his Crypt Swarm out, and that pushes the wave in a little bit. So Sheep is actually going to head down bottom. Timber Chain is not used. They know this because Universe just uses Whirling Death as well, and they're going to try to fight on him, maybe. Try to just take him out. And we'll see if they can get a kill here. It's going to be tough because he is very tanky. You have Lucent Beam. They might try to fight here. Sheep's going to come in, and Chant's going to go first. He has no usage of that Timber Chain. Whirling Death is going to fly. Dark Troll Warlord. I'm not sure where it went, but a lot of damage going. MSS, can he get this kill? Lucent Beam in 1 second. Salve is up. They have to break off the pursuit. Lucent Beam will break off the salve, but he could just regen using his tangos, and he'll be fine. So I don't know what happened to that Dark Troll Summoner. He had it for a minute, but it seems to have probably expired. And that's unfortunate because if they had the ensnare, they'd probably get that kill. And Universe ends up surviving because of it. So nice play there. He'll be just fine. And back to mid, we see RTZ doing very well. He's got a double damage. Maybe think about diving Ryu right now. He's taking a lot of tower damage. The salve is going to go, but only gets one hit off before it goes away. Now the Riptide gets the kill. RTZ still diving, but now getting chased by Cakes. Mirror images are going. Is he going to try to fight this? It looks like he will. The illusions will go on for a second, but Cakes wants to try to take this kill, but the Riptide going again. A double kill for RTZ. You gotta be kidding me, Cakes. You gotta realize that Riptide does some damage, and RTZ is still alive, and he is fine as well. He's got a bottle up. At least get to half health here, and Sheep can't do much about this, and that's unfortunate. It's 3-0 already for SADBOYS, and just RTZ being a man, diving behind the Tier 1 tower, grabbing a couple of kills because of it, so well played by the young mid player here. So in the top lane, Fear continuing to farm. He's sitting at 14 last hits, 15 now. Pandago has roamed down to, of course, the bottom lane, and he's just going to support, and they're sacking his top lane right now, and that is not good. They'll probably get Cakes up there, assuming he gets boots or something in relative short order, but with him dying, that really puts him behind, and this is going to be a tough game for them to come back into. Luckily, he's got a nice stack here, and he'll be able to take this with his Firefly in just a moment, but you know, they're leaving Fear alone. I mean, Fear can farm. We all know how good Fear can farm, so I don't know if this is really the best idea, because he'll get some decent CS, and he'll be able to roam and gank very effectively early on, too, because of it. So they will send Cakes up there right now, as I talked about. He doesn't have boots or anything. He's got Firefly, and he's actually going to use it just to try to get a little bit of CS here, but the wave is not, unfortunately, under the Firefly, or above the Firefly, excuse me, so he's not going to be able to do any damage. He'll try to get last hits here, but Universe checking out the 4-minute rune. It's going to be top, and Arteezy is going to grab that one with the illusions. He's going to send his mirror images mid, perhaps. There's a smoke gate coming through from PPD and Zai, and I talked about the roaming potential here, and Ryu has to be very careful, but he's sitting very low. You can see they probably called missing in that top lane. They know they're not there anymore, so Ryu's going to sit behind his tower, and this smoke gank probably is going to get snuffed out. While that's happening, MSS and the rest of his team are going to push in bottom, going to try to take this tier 1 tower. So if they can get this tower, that's going to be some much-needed gold to get back into this game. Luckily, MSS is having a very good time farming. He's got 25 last hits mid lane. There is going to be that dive. Song of the Siren is going to go through. Bane is here. He's only level 3. Ryu, hexed up. There's the Riptide. Crystal Nova taking a lot of damage. Frostbitten, silence. Nicely done, Crypt Swarm, but he will fall, and it'll be to the last hit of PPD's Crystal Maiden. Now, there's going to be the Respike. Arteezy can go again if he wants to, but it'd be very dangerous, and even with the TP rotation, they don't care. It doesn't matter. They still get the kill. While that's all happening, though, you see MSS takes the tower down bottom. He's got his treads. He's got his Basilius now as well, and that's at least one objective off the map for them. It's something to get him started here. Up at the top lane, Cakes is at 1,000 gold. He might even just go for a random, you know, just a blink dagger without boots. I don't think he would, but he could do so. I mean, he's at 1,000 gold right now. He just has to avoid getting hit with an arrow by Fear. So now roaming around mid again is Zai, and he's been effective once. Might just go again here on Ryu. So Ryu's got to play very passively, and in fact, he's going to get hexed right now. Earthspike's about to come. Maybe the ensnare first. There's the Earthspike. Ensnare may follow in just a moment. The right clicks should be enough. The bottle charges. One more right click for RTZ. He'll get the kill. Crypt Swarm, tower hit, not enough. Mirror images. Nice play, but Sheep's going to come through. Not enough damage there. One hit, maybe. Yes, Sheep does get the kill and at least get something out of that, but they're still down 5-1 right now. They only got one kill on the board, and that was just right there from Sheep. So RTZ, and And this is what you can do with the Naga Siren. Just dive behind towers, grab a couple of kills, and then just scoot right out of there afterwards. So he's done that like 3 or 4 times now. In fact, he's got 3 kills and 1 assist because of it. So at this point in time, also with Fear farming the way he is, they have to have some miraculous team fights with MSS here in the mid game to really get back into this one, I feel like, because Cakes isn't getting much yet. At least he's got his boots now. He's got a nice little sack here, but they have not touched Fear at all in that top lane. MSS has gotten somewhat free farm as well, but, you know, Universe has been in the lane and done a pretty good job of at least getting CS and keeping pace there. Speaking of him, he's almost at his arcane boots right now, and, well, I mean, this guy, he likes to dunk on people. He's known for it, in fact, so we'll see if he can have some huge plays with that Timber Saw and maybe 3 or 4 man Chakrams rolling deaths all over the place and Timber Chain. So they also have the Dire Advantage too, so maybe expect somebody to build a Medallion. And with the Riptide as well, with the armor reduction, that should affect Roshan. I'm pretty sure it does. So I expect SADBOYS to take the Roshan objective at, you know, once they get some tier 1 towers at least. So, but what is Arteezy going for right now? He's got almost 2,000 gold in the bank. He might even just go for that early relic that he's known for into that Radiance that he's done from time to time. So we are going to get a bit of a pause here. MSS is going to disconnect and hopefully reconnect in just a moment. So stick around, everybody. Hopefully we're not stuck in this pause for too long. Enchantress is going to grab a Buckler and has that Ring of Regen chainmail, obviously, so the Buckler's done thereabouts. And, of course, after that, mech's going to be really, you know, the option you want to go for. I mean, there's no point in building a Buckler if you're not going to build a mech. It's kind of silly. So, I mean, that's the items shouldn't be coming out for either team just yet. I mean, there is, like, some items coming out from SADBOYS. You see the Arcane Boots, like I talked about. I mean, you've got Phase and a Basilius as well. Tranquil's is pretty good on both of your supports already. That's pretty nice, so... and they realize they don't need to build Arcanes because Universe already has one. They just want to get speed and survivability, and Trinkle Boots will give them that. Arteezy is actually the only person that has Brown Boots right now. That's because he's rushing a Relic, probably. And the other side of things, you've got just Brown Boots on a couple heroes and Treads up on MSS and the Luna. So there really aren't that many items coming out for eHug now, and they've got to get some farm across the map, and it's just going to be difficult to do so. There's a nice little ward here, too, that they're going to spot out Cakes, and in fact, they probably will die. This Universe is going to come in from the backside. He does get spotted. Cakes actually might have saw him there.
Radiant's seen him. Top tower is
can't even speak
attack.
English. Jeez. Cakes, maybe just... He's backing up. I think he knows that he's there right now. He realizes he doesn't want to go too far forward and try to defend his tower. Maybe with Pandago they'll go forward, but once again, Universe is still right there, ready to go at a moment's notice right now. However, she is rotating through. And Universe thinking Radiant's about jumping on some heroes here. They're getting ready to dive, I think. They want to take this tower, maybe throw out an arrow first, and there it goes. Arrow's going to fly. Cakes, oh, he's going to walk right into it. No, Cakes. That's going to be a long duration stun. Timber Chain Chakra going to go through the trees. They're going to grab an easy kill. I can't believe he didn't see that. Well, Fear already hitting arrows, and that's what I was talking about. So, well played. And just like that, he's going to pick up a Hand of Midas recipe at 8 minutes in, so... If this game goes long, he'll be just fine with it because he'll have a lot of farm at about, you know, 20, 30 minutes even. And speaking of a lot of farm, there's 2,700 gold in the Naga Siren played by Arteezy. He's got a haste rune going right now. Double damage is bottled up, and he's having a very good time. He's died once, but that's fine. His last hit's right now sitting at 41 here. Top lane, TP's coming, come through. That's going to be MSS. He's going to just try to farm another lane here. There's going to be a Lucent Beam, and MSS is probably fine. He's just going to have to be careful, of course, of that arrow, and... He can even try to go on with an Eclipse if he catches Fear out of position, but that probably won't happen. So, eHug are, you know, kind of grouping up with their 3 supports, or 2 supports and Cakes, excuse me, down here in this bottom jungle, and maybe just try to gank Arteezy, but he does have that song, so you have to kill him very quickly if you are going to go on him. But it looks like they're just going to stick to the jungle right now and get some farm. And, well, and that means that Zai and PPD are going to do the same thing here. Zai is farming the jungle right now. He's got his Earth Spike. He also has, of course, his Mana Drain, which is scaled up to level 1. Illusions coming through, and Arteezy is going to do a really good job of this throughout the entire game. Is just scout things out with your illusions, make sure you have vision, and farm with them as well, which he's doing a very good job of. So, at this point in time, you know, you have your Enchantress, and you want to try to push with it, but it's tough because there's a lot of damage you'd have to push into through Universe. Obviously, Arteezy can just kind of stop a fight on its, you know, on its head with Song of the Siren. You have to be careful of the arrow and Moonlight Shadow to boot. So, there's a whole lot you have to worry about when you're pushing into SADBOYS' lineup. For SADBOYS, they could just keep playing like this. Get Arteezy his Relic, get Arteezy his Radiance, and then start really just trying to push down towers or split pushing or whatever, what have you. And Universe can control a lot of these fights as well. So at this point in time, I want to check what the graphs are real quick. There's the 2,000 gold lead coming out for SADBOYS, and I guess that's not really a surprise considering how much they've dominated early on here, as well as the 2,000 experience lead. So At 10 minutes in, that's pretty damn good. Like, Ryu is probably not feeling too great about his team right now and how they're playing, but, you know, there are opportunities to get back into it, and the problem with Death Prophet is you want to get to that level 2 ultimate as quickly as possible, and you can see he's not trying to push down towers with his ultimate because he knows that he can't really do much with it, unless they have to force something, which they might do now, so... Level 2 ultimate is really what you want to get right now, but he's not really close. He's only at level 8, and that's not the best experience from right now. Obviously, Naga's at 9, so it's not too bad, but they're going to group up, and this isn't going to facilitate any leveling experience for you. Universe is going to throw out his Chakram right now, try to push them back, and Buckler is going to get popped, but this tower is at full health, so this is going to be tough to push this down. Ryu will throw his exorcism out, and already a lot of damage being done, but the fortification is going to go. And this gives a lot more time for, obviously, Artesia to farm bottom, maybe try to push that in, Fear up in the top lane. They probably won't TP for this. I'd be surprised if they do. I mean, they can fight if they want to with Song of the Siren. And we'll have to keep our eye on Artesia. He doesn't have a TP right now. He's going to sell us Sick and probably buy a TP and Song in and if necessary. But we'll see. I mean, you can see Split pushing already. Tier 2 tower taking damage from Fear. Exorcism still going. Tier 1 tower is going to fall. They have to TP top or bottom. They have to make a decision. Artesia's going to be fine down here up top. Air's going to go. Actually, Pandago canceled that TP. They're going to go bottom instead. Arteezy, he has that song. Lucid Beam's going to go. Will he use it to get out of a bad position? I'm sure if he needs to. He's just going to TP out, in fact. Cancel the TP coming out from MSS, but he's fine. He's not going to die or anything like that. So he doesn't have to use the song, and that's actually really good because the song cooldown is very long early on. So it's been a bit of a mistake, but now it looks like they're going to smoke in. Arteezy's kind of low, but it looks like it's just going to be Universe and Zai on a two-man ganking mission here against MSS, and MSS has got to be careful. Luckily, he's got that Ogre Club, but he needs to buy something. He actually doesn't have enough money to buy a Mithril Hammer or anything like that if he gets ganked, but TP reactions may be coming soon, so we'll see. Moonlight Shadow's going to go, and that's going to facilitate the gank right now. Universe is going to go in, look for the Chakram first. No, the Hex is going to go. There's going to be the Finger of Death. A lot of damage, a lot of hate on MSS, that poor guy. He will go down, but in the top lane here, Pandago also in trouble. Nightmare is going to go. Magic Stick, he's not getting any help. Brain Sap as well, but the right clicks are a lot of damage. Fear may take him down. Enfeeble's going to go. TP coming through, and that TP saves the life of Pandago, who is very low in health, and that was a lot of damage just for Phase Boots and a Midas, so... The fact that Fear does that kind of damage to Pandago just means that Pandago is very, very, very squishy. He's level 5 right now. He is almost level 6, so there is that. And he really does need that level 6 to get to Fiend's Grip. That's going to be a big help against something like the Timbersaw, like the Naga Siren played by Arteezy. So, but it's 1-7 right now up in the top lane. They do grab the kill on the Marana. I did miss that, but I'm assuming the Lasso was used, and in fact it was. The Blink Dagger is done for Cakes now, so at least he's got that going for him. And it wasn't too late either, so Cakes is feeling pretty good about his Blink timing. MSS is still trying to get to that BKB, but with that death, it's not going to help. And they're going to try to maybe push top here as Rui's going to come through on the backside. I think this is Zai, and he still doesn't have his finger, obviously, he just used it, but he's going to sit very low underneath the tower. Timbersaw will take the tower down bottom, so they kind of just let a tier 1 go for nothing, and hopefully they get a tier 1 tower out of it, but SADBOYS are playing on all cylinders, they're firing on all cylinders right now. Arteezy's going to go mid with the help of the Crystal Maiden, just try to push this down. Ryu's going to throw out his Crypt Swarm and just try to push this back as quickly as possible, but Arteezy may keep going here with his Mirror Images. Up the top lane, they will take that tower, they'll back off potentially. Cakes is going to TP, looks like he's going to go home, but Universe down to that bottom lane, still pushing in. Radiance is done at 1320 for Arteezy. Kind of a disgustingly fast Radiance for the mid players, so that's pretty damn good. And now it's really going to be annoying because he'll just be able to split push and just do so much damage. I mean, the damage he's going to do to all these squishy heroes on the Radiant team is disgusting. So there is a Smoke and Deceit coming out from Pandago right now. They're going to try to get something going. And with PPD here, maybe they can find him in the jungle, but I think they're probably going to make this kind of line here. Go mid and try to find somebody in the jungle. Or they can do this. If my geometry on my minimap wasn't messed up. Volvo, please. So Ryu, Staff of Wizardry. He's trying to get to that Yule Scepter, it seems. Arrow flying through. No. Too far. Not on target. They knew it was coming anyway, so. What's kind of an issue is Sheep is pretty close to Universe right now, and Universe could definitely kill Sheep, but Smoke Gank rotation. And I think that Universe, as well as PPD, know that something's coming here. They've got to be very careful. Universe is going to go into lane, and Sheep may try to bait this. Universe is sitting very low. You can see where the tower would be. This is kind of one of those juke spots, but they're going the wrong way. Cakes is just trying to check the Ancient Tech first and foremost, but they should know that PPD is still here, as well as Universe, and We'll see if they can find anybody. They should find PPD. They have Lasso ready to go for kicks. Is he going to get it? Blank. Oh, Frostbite, but it doesn't matter. He gets the Lasso anyways. There's going to be the Moonlight Shadow going through. Do they have detection? I'm not sure. Sheep doesn't have it right now. What about Pandago? He's here, but he's coming up on the backside. He's late to the party. PPD is going to TP away. He will make it out in time, and that's just because you're not carrying detection. Oh, poor Sheep. Poor eHug. They got to get their head in the game right now. But once again, Arteezy doing a nice job of pushing. And this time, Fear is in the action as well with his Midas. He's got 2,000 gold to make. He's got, of course, the Ring of Health as well. Might go for a Lincoln Sphere. I'm not sure. Nightmare. No tower denied, but Arteezy, he has that song like we talked about. Silence is going to go, though. He's going to get Fiend's Grip, but it gets canceled. There's going to be the... oh, he gets it off just in time. He got the...